Nantucket or something to get ready.
It always is.
I don't know.
One game. Enjoy the game. I know you'd rather be up there. Of course, the game begins at 8:00 Eastern Time. Dustin Pedroia not in the lineup. Kevin Youkilis not in the lineup, but they're still playing tonight. As we move towards the game, Bobby V, John Brunkery join me. Highlights the Reds and the Cubs. The Reds in Chicago, and they're going for the sweep. They've won 11 of their last 13 series. Haven't swept any of them. Jay Bruce puts them up 2-0. Apparently, they play the Cubs. Not until this one.
And 2 out of 3 in a pennant race is just what you need.
Keep winning series,
right? Yes, sir.
Jeff Baker into the hole. Oh, Giannis to the back end. Got him.
Who needs Cabrera?
He's really playing great in Cabrera's stead.
It's been a recurring theme is that other players have been in crucial spots and helped their teams out. The Reds do get the sweep. They beat the Cubs by a score of 11-4. Otto hits his 28th of the season. We've given you the tale of the tape of the East and the West. Take a look at the Central. And by the way, we got ourselves a game coming up between the Cardinals and the Reds tomorrow out on the ESPN.
That's going to be huge. If you look at the bottom stat right here, 43 errors for 72 for the Cubs. That's the difference right now in the division.
All right, let's go over this series. Crews that are going to be pitching for the St. Louis Cardinals. And of course, the first game is going to be 7 Eastern on ESPN Monday night. You're going to have to deal with Carpenter, you're going to have to deal with Garcia, and you're going to have to deal with Wainwright. Does that reek of a sweep for the Cardinals?
2-3? On paper, yes, it does, because the pitch matchup, although Johnny Cueto's going to start,
he's in the middle.
He's pretty good. Leesville got lit up his last start against the Pirates, so. You know, again, I think Chris Carpenter, what he does, he set the tone for this series. But if he can pitch like he had prior to his last start, it's going to be a hell of a series.
Is there a little energy that could kind of feel on the Reds? I mean, or is it just me who thinks that now you got to believe in this team?
Well, you have one team that has the best players. You have those three pitchers John mentioned, and you have a full host, and you have a Holiday who are making hundreds of millions of dollars, and then you have the Reds. So what I'm looking at is the underdog first place team, the Reds,
right,
taking this series.
They are first place. You're looking at them to take this series?
Yes.
Is Otto an MVP in the league right now? 28 home runs.
He needs to finish with 6 more strong weeks.
And that is going to have a subtext in this whole series. Otto versus Pujols.
Leon, the new guy against the old guy.
Right. The Reds against the Cardinals.
Howard's 30.
Yeah, and then we'll
get your established guy.
Monday at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Baseball, and that will be on right after that. And another guy who's going to be in that MVP discussion.
He's going to win some.
Carlos Gonzalez, 25th of the year. Rockies go up 2-0. I know we said 16th to 4th spot. They need to win a few games. A couple series before you. I think you got to take the Rockies series.
Yeah, they've been very inconsistent. Just when you think they're going to get on the run, they fall back and lose a few here and there. It's going to be tough for them.
8-4, the Rockies do beat the Pirates. What a miracle victory the Pirates had yesterday. The wild card race. Now the Giants are on top. The Phillies, Cardinals, and Rockies. That's where Colorado has some credibility. They're only 4 behind in the loss column in the wild card race.
Yeah, but they have to jump over the Giants in the card race to get one of those teams to get there.
That's not going to be easy. Mr. 600, Alex Rodriguez. He'll sit on the hot seat between Bobby and I and talk about hitting 600, coming back from